According to the president, NRM's vision and mission is to have all the masses shown the way to prosperity, mostly through commercial agriculture. He has urged the business people to help government in this area in order for their businesses to thrive and be sustained. The president, who is on an investment and wealth creation tour in West Nile under the theme, Securing Your Future Through Wealth Creation and Shared Prosperity, informed the gathering that all Ugandans must be supported to engage in commercial agriculture using the 4 acres model and the 7 activities proposed in the NRM manifesto. The 7 activities include growing of coffee, fruits, food crops, zero grazing dairy cattle, poultry, piggery and fish farming.
And these who are growing coffee can give testimony how much they are earning per acre per annum.
Bab sad si kawa zopidi, it's what evini your things idea, eka losi. Kawa mi send the susiri, but it's what your learn zera.
The 2nd acre. You put fruits, especially mangoes, oranges, or pineapples.
Eka ziria mi pati fisa mango pile, dima pile, afazeni ba nyanya diipie.
2nd, 3rd acre, you put pasture for zero grazing cows for milk.
Eka nazurma midi ribisa ti zozo bani lira midi fe ti idri ba tini tinde diipie ti etiko midi lombe pari lombelo ribili midi idri.
4th acre, you put food crops. And if you are not a Muslim, you can also have pigs.
Islam
in the backyard. But
on the concern of roads, the president reiterated government's commitment to maintain the roads once constructed, but also to constantly check on the quality of the constructed roads to avoid shoddy work. The president also ordered for the arrest of all those involved in staging multiple roadblocks to collect taxes from the business people, saying roadblocks were abolished a long time ago.
Like I was hearing, the multiple roadblocks for collecting taxes, district by district, all these will be arrested. Anybody who puts a roadblock to collect taxes will be, the one who sends him will be arrested, and he himself will be arrested.
The Minister for Finance in charge of investments, Evelyn Anite, informed the president that in line with his directive, land has been secured in different districts of West Nile to establish industrial parks.
In your future through wealth creation for shared prosperity. One of the key factors of production is land. Your Excellency, I thank you very, very much for giving the land titles to the people of West Nile. Let us clap for the President. Your Excellency, you did guide that we should have industrial parks in all the 18 zones of Uganda. You gave a number of 25 industrial parks. You gave us a guidance that you want the land to be unencumbered. Mr. President, you also gave us guidance that we should ensure that the land of industrial parks should be 500 acres and above.
The meeting was also attended and addressed by the Vice President, Major Retired Jessica Alupo. Other ministers were Obiga Kania for Urban Development, Dr. Joyce Moreko Kadichu for Primary Education, Jeno Katumba Wamala, the Works and Transport Minister, Dr. Chris Bariomunsi, the Minister for ICT and National Guidance, and Ruth Nankabira for Energy and Mineral Development. Others in attendance included the NRM Secretary General, Richard Todong, Honorable Members of Parliament from Arua, and officials from Uganda Revenue Authority and Uganda Investment Authority.